Hello everyone. Today I shall be explaining you the topic accessibility option, which comes under the first session of the first unit, that is web applications for class 10th. The first term that we need to understand in this particular chapter is that what is computer accessibility? Computer accessibility is actually the user friendliness of a computer system for everyone. A person can have some or the other form of disability which makes that person unable to use a computer system normally in a better way, or we can call it in a friendly way. Now, this issue is basically a software issue and can be dealt with by making certain settings in the operating system like Windows. And these accessibility options, or we can call it as the assistive technology also, it enables a person with disability or impairment to use a computer system normally in a better way. Now, before moving ahead to understand that how these accessibility options are set, let us first of all understand what are the various types of impairments or disabilities that are dealt with these options. The first one I am picking up is cognitive impairment, or we can call it as a learning disability. We have already heard of a few terms called as dyslexia, ADHD, which stands for attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, and we might have also heard about autism. Now, these are actually the difficulties which make a particular person unable to read, comprehend a situation, or have some difficulty in learning or understanding a particular thing. Now, these impairments can be dealt with. Now, I'm moving ahead to motor and dexterity impairments. These are the impairments which are actually related to a person's inability to control the mouse or the keyboard because of some motor inabilities. If a person is unable to move hands because of various problems, it can be like paralysis, it can be cerebral palsy, carpal tunnel syndrome, repetitive strain injuries can be there. Then there can be certain injuries or the loss of the hands or fingers. Stiffness in the finger joints also make a person unable to use a mouse or keyboard. Then a person might also have some sorts of tremors which make him very difficult situation where he can use a computer system nicely or to use a mouse or a keyboard in a proper way. Now, another types of impairments that we are going to understand are visual impairments and the hearing impairments. Complete or partial blindness, color blindness, impaired eyesight due to various diseases like glaucoma, cataract, etc., and various age-related disease of the eye, they all fall under visual impairments. We have seen that with age, our eyes tend to deteriorate, our vision tend to deteriorate. So this also falls under visual impairment. Another thing that is hearing impairment, here, what is there? There are certain issues which are dealt with a computer, like in certain exceptional situations where some errors are generated, then a sort of a beep or a warning sound is generated by the computer. Now, in that particular case, when a person is unable to hear well, that person might miss on various warnings generated by the computer system. So, this is called as hearing impairment, which causes hindrance for a person to use a computer system normally. Now, I shall be moving on to how actually we can set up various options which make a computer system user-friendly for a person having disabilities. The thing that I'm going to explain now is very, very important. It is having a practical set of a usage here, that is launching accessibility options. How do we actually launch accessibility options? All the accessibility options are present in control panel. The control panel is present in the start button. So first of all, we have to click start button and then we have to select control panel. The control panel's window will be opened. Now, when the control panel's window is opened, like here, I have shown it here, we can see that in the control panel window, we are having this ease of access option, which is present as the last option here. Once we click over this option, then we will have to select ease of access center, as we can see here. That means first we need to click on ease of access and then we have to click on ease of access center. Now these accessibility options, they can also be launched with a shortcut key, and that is Windows plus U. Now once these accessibility options are launched, we can make few settings here and there which will help the people with disabilities to work in a computer system normally. Now, the first option that I'm picking up is the sticky keys. It is an accessibility feature of Microsoft Windows, which helps a computer user with certain physical disabilities or a person who is having some repetitive strain issue to use a computer system well. Like this, the option of sticky keys can be understood well with the example of, suppose a person has to press Ctrl, Alt and Del keys together to log off Windows. Now imagine a person who is just having one hand, or maybe another hand is there but another hand is not working. So for that particular person, pressing all the three keys together is going to be a little difficult, which can easily be solved by this sticky keys option. Now, how this option is set? For this, we need to click on start. Then we have to click on control panel to open it. And then we shall be clicking on ease of access option. And then we shall be invoking ease of access center, as I told you earlier. Now, in the ease of access center, we get numerous options. Here, to set the sticky keys option, we need to select make the keyboard easier to use option. That means under the ease of access center, we have to select make the keyboard easier to use. Now, once we select this option, we get the window as I have shown below. We can see in this window that the second option here is turn on sticky keys. So when we click on the option turn on sticky keys, when we click on this check mark of turn on sticky keys, then this option is set. Furthermore, there is another option, that is set up sticky keys. So once we click on this option, we can further customize this feature for a better use, for more optimum use for the disabled people. Now, I'm moving on to my next topic or next accessibility option, that is filter keys. Filter keys is an option, accessibility feature, which is present in Microsoft Windows that tells the keyboard to ignore brief or repeated keystrokes, making the typing easier for the people with hand tremors. The people who are having hand tremors, they have difficulty in typing because once they press one key, that means one key press actually does not produce one instance of that character on the screen. But instead what comes? Multiple occurrences of the same character appear on the screen. Now this is an issue. How to tackle it? Again, we have to invoke the ease of access center. Click on start, then click on control panel, then select the ease of access option and then click on ease of access center. Now again here, we have to press make the keyboard easier to use option. Now here, instead of pressing sticky keys option, we will be clicking on turn on filter keys checkbox option. So the same options are there for the sticky keys as well as the filter keys. Here also, like the sticky keys option, we can do setting up of the filter keys by clicking on setup filter keys option to further customize it for more optimal use. Now I am moving ahead to another option, another accessibility feature, that is toggle keys. This feature is designed for people who have vision impairment or cognitive disabilities. Toggle keys, there are, first of all, let us understand which toggle keys are there on a normal keyboard. There are three toggle keys on a keyboard, which is caps lock, num lock, and scroll lock. These are the keys which are actually in the off and on mode present on the keyboard. If we press caps lock, so once it is pressed on, if another time, if it is again pressed, then the caps lock is turned off. Similarly, num lock, pressed once, it will be on. Pressed again, it will be off. The same applies to scroll lock also. That means these three keys, they work in a toggle function. They work in a toggle manner. They are invoked once, and then they can be made off by clicking again. Now, whenever a person with some vision impairment uses such keys, then what happens? The person might have pressed a caps lock key by mistake, or the num lock key by mistake because of some vision impairment, or a person who is having cognitive disability, that means to the disability to understand things easily. He might have also pressed one of these keys by mistake. So if these keys are pressed by a mistake, then also they are going to function in the same manner if they are pressed actually nicely. That means, just imagine a situation where a person who cannot see, he has pressed the caps lock key by a mistake, and now all the characters are coming in capitals, and he won't be able to understand. He might not be able to see also that everything is coming in the capitals. Now what to do? That means there has to be certain option which will help these people to handle such situations. So for this toggle keys option is present. Now let us understand how do we set up toggle keys. The option of toggle keys is also present in the control panel's ease of access center. That means the first and the second point are altogether same. Here again, we shall be selecting make the keyboard easier to use. And then we shall be clicking on which option? Turn on toggle keys checkbox option. As we can see, it is present as the third option under make the keyboard easier to use. I hope that I am able to clarify all the topics which come under the accessibility options related to the use of keyboards. In my next session, I shall be moving ahead to more accessibility options. Thank you so much.